Hey, I'm Will Welker. So in this video, we're going to look at WebVR as experienced in a browser using the Chromium experimental browser build. And Blend4Web has a demo online that you can go and download and watch, or if you have the SDK already installed, you can find the demo under code snippets. And I'll show you where that is as well. So as we go through this, I'll kind of explain what it was like to experience it, and also I'll put links in the description below. If you want to do the same thing, you need to go download the Chromium browser and do various things to get set up for it. So I've pointed my browser to using the experimental Chromium browser build, and I've gone ahead and opened up this Blend4Web WebVR demo. And so I'll go ahead and get strapped in and pick up my two hand controllers. And the first thing that struck me about this is how well these hand controllers are modeled. With the view you can see here, there's a little bit of a distortion, but from the first person virtual reality view, they're very well modeled and they track perfectly. And so what I'm doing here is I'm in a scene where physics have been enabled, and this is a very simple scene. It's just a flat background, and you have these two lasers that extend from each Vive controller, and when you pull the trigger, it'll pick up whatever your laser is pointing at. And so you can pick objects up and toss them around, and they behave with physics. And you have the normal room scale movement that you can move around with, but also wherever your targets happen to be pointing. If you're pointing on the ground, then you hit the thumb pad and it teleports you to that location. So you have that sort of blink teleport ability. And the reason it's done that way is movement in VR has to be done carefully or it makes you sick. So one way of overcoming that is either make it so you can move in your play area, and that feels natural to your brain, or you point your controller somewhere and teleport there, and that doesn't confuse your brain. What can happen if you're standing still, but then you know you're moving your character in a game? It can confuse your mind and makes you ill. There are ways to do it, and I think there's getting to be games that accomplish that. But at this point, that's done primarily to keep you from getting motion sickness. But this was very realistic. This was really high quality. It's the kind of quality you expect to see in games that run natively on your computer rather than in a browser like this. So I think this is definitely the future of the internet. This was very natural. I wasn't visiting a web page. I was in an environment. I was there. So I could pick things up and build. And so one of the next things I want to do is take this example file they've given and go ahead and customize it and do some additional things to it, put some textured objects in and see what I can do, because I found this very compelling. So I did notice if I got close to the edge of my play area, it seemed like the tracking wasn't at 100%. And I think that's partially due to how the technology stack works. You have the Vive, and then you have the browser. And I haven't tried this in the Firefox experimental browser build yet. So basically, you have the Blend4Web technology is built on top of the browser. So one is dependent on the other for this to work. So it felt very natural to move these objects around. You could just pick something up and toss it and catch it with the other controller, and it felt like being there. This demo didn't have any sound, and so I was thinking, you know, that's one thing I want to explore is putting sound in it. I think that's well within Blend4Web's ability. I haven't gotten to the code yet to see, but getting sound in, so like crashing sounds or just, you know, sounds for when collisions occur, that's something I want to explore on this, because that would be really compelling. So here I'm getting, you can see that bounding box. That's a function of the Vive. The Vive shows you that when you're getting close to the end of your play area. And when I got close to that, the tracking, my head tracking wasn't at 100%. If I was more towards the center of my play area, the head tracking was very good. And so I think, as the name implies, the Chromium experimental browser build, it's gonna be improving. But you know, when I first tried VR a year ago, it made you ill, it was difficult, resolution was poor, and I didn't see the vision so much, but now it's different. This is real. And you can throw them and toss them. I was thinking when I was playing this that it would be a really cool game idea was if you were like picking up boulders and tossing them at like a castle wall or something, and the physics was used to break holes in the castle wall. It would be really, I think that would be really compelling browser game idea. Here I was examining the controllers, and I don't know if Blend4Web team designed these controllers, or if Vive has 3D files that they let you use. I'm not sure, but these were totally real. I mean, the lighting on them, everything. It was, and the tracking was perfect. So as you watch the controller move, it mirrored what was going on in your hand perfectly. So if you want to see the future of the internet, I think this is it. I think this is what it's going to be like on the internet. When you visit somewhere, you're going to be there. You're not going to be looking at a page. The concept of a web page, I think, is going to change to a web environment. And so here I'm just experimenting with the navigation. I'm just clicking myself around. It works with either controller, wherever your target is on the ground, when you hit the thumb pad and you just appear there. So if you have a Vive and you want to try this out, you can come to this website, and I'll link to it below, to get instructions on where to set up your Chromium experimental browser build. And you can, from here, it'll give you different instructions depending on what platform you have. And so, since I have the Vive, and this demo is specifically for the Vive, I followed the instructions for setting up the Vive, and it'll link you around to the various setup instructions. And so here I went into Chromium and actually set up or enabled the WebVR, and this is the experimental Chromium build. And then it'll tell you to go to this, you know, enter this address in your browser, and it will enable the gamepad extension. So I just copied that, and I'll just enter the search term here and then go ahead and make sure that's enabled. Now I've already enabled this, so when you first do it, it's not enabled. So here's where you download the Chromium browser. I'll have a link for this as well in the description below. All right, to activate this in your SDK, with Blender open and your Blend4Web add-on active, go ahead and open your SDK index. And we are on version 17.04. So this example is going to be in code snippets. Just pull that up, and then down on the lower left here you'll see where it says VR. And then right down here where it says VR not available, if I have my Vive turned on and plugged in, this will show that it's available. And so you can just click that, and then it sends the experience to your Vive headset. if you don't have your SDK installed and you still want to experience this on your Vive, you can just go to their website and view it from there, and I'll have a link for that in the description. All right, so I'm going to do some more work in this area, so stay tuned and we'll see you later.